From the AFRTS News Center in Washington, this is a News Center Extra. I'm Air Force Sergeant Amy Canna. Earlier this week, Secretary of Defense William Cohen rolled out the administration's spending plan for fiscal year 2001. Just minutes after his news conference at the Pentagon, Secretary Cohen sat down with the News Center's Army Sergeant Mike Wetzel. Sergeant Wetzel began by asking the Secretary what he most wanted service members to know about his budget proposal.
What I want them to understand is that we have been listening to their needs. As I looked at the budget over the last 3 years, there are three or four issues that kept coming to the surface. Number one, we needed more pay. That has been achieved with the 4.8 pay raise. This next year's budget will include an additional pay raise of 3.7, which is higher than the Employment Consumer Index, which is about a half a percentage point higher. So we're going to actually do better than in the private sector. Secondly, I've looked at we had the retirement last year. This builds upon that. We've looked at also the housing allowance, where you have some members living off base who have to pay almost 19% out of their pocket. That's going to change. We're going to get it down to 15% for the fiscal 01 budget, and then we'll get it reduced to zero, so there'll be no out-of-pocket expenses. The third major area to look at is what we're trying to do with TRICARE. The health care system has not been managed in the way that is most desirable and most effective. We are undertaking to find ways in which we can ease the access for members to have quick access to medical facilities, to ease their out-of-pocket costs should they have to go off base and receive treatment in the private sector, so there'll be no copay, to take those families who are at fairly distant geographical locations, so-called TRICARE Prime remote, and also eliminate those co-payments, and then to try to devise a system whereby we can make this as seamless as possible when any of the men and women get transferred from one region to another. They don't have to go through a long, laborious, complex process of re-enrolling, finding out they have different benefits. And we're trying to streamline that and make it as easy as we can for the families. And then we have to deal with other issues, of course, the retirement community. And the chairman and I are trying to work our way through to see what kind of recommendations we can make that we certainly have an obligation to pursue.
Now, you have met with service members all around the world. Are these the issues that they have brought forward to you and told you are important to them?
These are the key issues. Obviously, they're concerned about having spare parts and equipment. They want to be ready. Some of the units certainly who are not on the front lines being the first to respond, being required to respond, have found shortages of spare parts. We have put additional funding in the budget to provide those spare parts so that that will contribute to the readiness and to their morale. It's very demoralizing for our troops to have to be cannibalizing other equipment or have to wait for long periods of time before equipment arrives. So in order to fix the systems that they are required to work on. So we're putting more money into the spare parts budget as well and trying to accelerate that. That's another major factor. But the items of pay, retirement, health care, and housing have been the preeminent ones that they have talked about.
Sir, these items you've just talked about, like the pay and the retirement, how much do you think they will affect recruiting and retention?
I think they'll have a very positive impact. I know that I went out to visit one of our ships. I reenlisted some 12 sailors, and I asked them why they were reenlisting. Well, they loved the job, but number one, they said that you're listening to us. The pay has been a big help, the retirement benefits. We know that you're hearing what we're saying. And so I've tried to make it the mark of my own tenure as Secretary of Defense to deal with quality of life issues, because all of this great equipment that we have will be relatively unimportant if we don't have good people and the best people to operate it. So we've got to attract the best and the brightest, then we've got to keep them. And so quality of life issues are critically important to achieving both of those objectives.
Secretary of Defense William Cohen talking with the News Center's Army Sergeant Mike Wetzel about the fiscal year 2001 budget he sent to Congress this week. This has been a News Center Extra. I'm Air Force Sergeant Amy Canna in Washington. Thanks for joining us.
This is the Armed Forces Radio and Television Service.